Welcome to Beyond the Noise. Here's Olivet Nazarene University's chaplain, Mark Holcomb.
I was afraid this was going to happen. Anytime we have days in the 60s in January usually means one thing. Winter hasn't arrived. You know, the logic is it should be warmer and milder in February than January, right? Then the stupid groundhog has to come out of his hole and see his shadow. We've all just been duped. Thanks for nothing, Punxsutawney Phil. You ever been duped? Besides concerning the weather. Yeah, it doesn't feel good, does it? I looked up the word, and it means a person who is easily deceived or fooled, gullible. Well, ever felt duped? I don't know how I feel about this 12 inches of snow that they're predicting. I thought, or should I say hope, like many of you, we were going to have a mild winter, but I guess that's yet to be seen. But if what they're predicting for us is true, I don't know if I'm happy about this one bit. Now, I love snowstorms, but I feel like we've been duped. We've been set up. Sometimes this happens because you trust someone, and other times it happens because you thought you knew the way things were going to go down, thought you had things figured out, only to find out you just got it all wrong. I mean, who likes to be duped anyway? I don't know. I like that word, duped. There are times those watching us think they recognize when we're being duped. You ever had that happen before? Where we think certain things and people look at us think we're being duped? I think that's the way the religious leaders felt about those following Jesus. This call to follow him. You know, this man from Nazareth, born into abject poverty without reputation, calling others to follow him? For what? The religious leaders weren't the last to feel this way, but were in a long line of folks throughout the Jesus narratives that just couldn't believe how anyone could buy what Jesus was selling. It's why Mark declares early in his story that there was a plot in the 3rd chapter 6th verse to destroy Jesus. That came on pretty quick. And yet, they followed him. They followed him and they watched him in droves and they kept following. I mean, how do you know if what you're hearing is true or not? How do you know if you're being duped? I mean, the way of Jesus isn't easy. Children's stories like The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe recognize that following Jesus isn't safe. Remember the conversation between the beavers and Lucy when she asks about Aslan and the beavers acknowledge that Aslan isn't safe, but he's good? No one ever said following Jesus was going to be easy, not if they read the narrative. It's why Jesus' call is a call to service, to come and die. It's why he tells us to pick up our cross and carry it every day. He risked his own skin for the sake of the lost, the marginalized, the labeled, the outcast, the sinners, us. And then he looks at us and asks us to do the same. And the reason we do it? Do you know what the reason is we do it? Do you know why? Because we've met him. Salvation's not just from our sins, as amazing as that is, but Jesus saves us from ourselves, what we could do to ourselves and what we could do to others. Remember Nicodemus, the one who came to see Jesus questioning him in the dark? Then, later in the story, defending him publicly to the Sanhedrin? Eventually, assisting Joseph with his burial. Or remember the Samaritan woman at the well who couldn't understand what Jesus was trying to tell her, eventually going back to her town, and because of the story she told of her encounter with this man named Jesus at a well, convinced men and women alike of who this person Jesus is. Do you know what changed it for Nicodemus? Do you know what changed it for the woman at the well? Do you know what changed it for the adulterer in that back alley? They'd met him. It's what it took for the blind beggar and the leper and the friends of the paralytic and a tax collector and prostitutes and the likes of you and me. I don't like being duped. Some people think we're being duped. But you know what? We've met Jesus. And that changes everything.
This has been Beyond the Noise with Chaplain Mark Holcomb. Watch Olivet Chapel services live or on demand at olivet.edu. Beyond the Noise is a production of Shine.fm.